Hi, this is Editor's Take. I'm Sakshi Batra, and with me is Gaurav Choudhury, and we are here to discuss about the retail inflation data that has been released by the government last evening. Thanks a lot, Gaurav, for joining in. Well, CPI inflation for the month of October has actually inched up to a 16-month high at 4.6%. How big a concern is this, and what has really led to the spike in inflation this time?
Well, the spike in inflation this time clearly is because of food prices and primarily vegetable prices, and the reasons are quite straightforward, actually. It's because monsoons actually extended up to October this year. In fact, in many places, monsoon rates started retreating only by the second week of October. And that had its impact spread across the vegetable crop. And that is now playing out, showing up in the headline inflation numbers. Consumer food price inflation has also shot up. And it is primarily because of that. And as we know, food prices have in the retail inflation basket, food prices carry a weightage of about 44%, 44-45%. And clearly, if there's a spike in food inflation, that is going to swing the headline inflation similarly,
sure,
which seems to be happening here. Having said that, it'll get both the government and the RBI interested and also a little worried. If this were to persist, then it is above the RBI's tolerable limit of 4%. And if it at some point starts crossing 5% or even inches up towards the 5%, then that could be a little worrisome. But as of now, that doesn't seem to be happening, at least in the next month or so.
Right. I also wanted to ask you about the core inflation. I think that still is below 4%. So
yeah,
is that a breather, and what does that really indicate right now?
Yeah, so core inflation, as we know, is non-food, non-fuel inflation, and which is essentially the closest, it's a far better proxy to measure changes in trends in prices and also an indicator of economic activity. Very low core inflation, or persistently low core inflation, is not a good thing.
Okay.
And in fact, core inflation is now at a multi-year low.
Yeah.
It's about 3.3%, between 3.3 to 3.5%, which is something that should get the government a little worried, because the reason for creating an index like core inflation in within the discipline of economics is to essentially weed out the big fluctuating factors like food and fuel, and find out what is the level of economic activity or the pricing power that is seen in those that do not have, whose prices do not fluctuate so often as food and fuel.
Sure.
And in this case, it appears that there is very little pricing power of non-food, non-fuel items. And if the pricing power continues to remain low, it's an indicator of very weak demand, which seems that recovery will take longer. So clearly, what is happening in the economy, and this is again an indication of deepening deceleration, because if prices of products are not rising at a certain pace, then that means people aren't buying those products. And that is not a good sign. So that's a sign of very weak demand. That means the economy, if the economy were to recover, then demand push will have to take place.
Absolutely. So that is the big concern right now. I also wanted to point out, say, RBI in its last meeting, it had put the inflation forecast at 3.5 to 3.7%. But we've been seeing consistent inching up of the inflation. Do you think that band will also change now?
That might change, but I do not expect the RBI to change it in the December review.
Okay.
Because RBI, the Monetary Policy Committee, will be guided more by a longer pattern of price data, and their decisions and recommendations are always data driven, as we know. But what it raises a concern here is that if prices were to persist higher, it rules out the possibility, and if it continues to remain high for the next 3 or 4 months, the headline inflation rate, which is the main gauge that the RBI tracks for interest rate related decisions, if it continues to remain persistently above 4.5%, and then that will at some point in time rule out the possibility of further rate cuts. That could lead to a very difficult situation, because we could be looking at what is called stagflation. Stagflation is when there is high inflation and stagnant growth, which is not a good situation to be in, because then if the RBI cannot cut rates further and demand is weak and inflation continues to rise, we need to find out why is inflation is rising when there is weak demand, and two, how do you contain inflation and also push growth? I think both the RBI and the government will have job we'll have the task cut out.
Absolutely. And for the December policy now, what do you think the RBI will do, considering the IIP is coming, has shrunk to minus 4.3%,
yes, so,
and the inflation is now inching up?
So I would assume that the RBI will actually go for another round of rate cut.
Okay.
Because RBI will be guided more by what is happening in core inflation. Core
okay.
inflation is low. And at this point in time, it is reflective of, as I said, low pricing power and weak demand. And that is also showing up in the factory output data, which was minus 4.3%
in
the month of September. October, it may have picked up a bit, but by the time the RBI presents its policy, the October data will not be out. But going by whatever October IIP data will not be out, but whatever data is available, RBI will probably be guided more by what's happening in core inflation.
Yeah.
That seems to be quite low. And I would expect RBI will probably go and announce another round of rate cuts. But having said that, its impact on reviving growth as of now appears to be a little limited.
Absolutely. Thanks a lot, Gaurav, for sharing all that insight. While the high inflation or the spike in inflation is definitely a concern, on the other hand, lower or prolonged weaker core inflation is also not good, because it indicates weak demand. It's a double whammy kind of a situation for the RBI. So all eyes will be on the commentary that RBI governor will make in terms of what forecast do they have for inflation going forward, and what is the kind of policy action that they would continue to do in the next year as well. Thanks a lot for joining us in this edition of Editor's Take, and do stay logged on to moneycontrol.com for more news and updates. Thanks for watching.